think Doom has just got the craziest talent pool, you know? It's really insane what he has at level 10. I think extra 275 HP or 80 bonus Devour Gold. That's crazy as well. That gives him so much more money. And then you have the... And then you have the Scorch of Heal. That one's a no-brainer. And then you have the Doom damage, which can pretty much take out a hero, actually kill him with that spell. Lock him down for that amount of seconds.
Have
and
the,
heal him, most likely.
Scorch of Heal. That one's a no-brainer.
And then you have the Doom damage, and which can pretty much take out a hero. The ability Ancient Creeps. Granite Golem, the Thunderhide. All pretty insane. Now, I'm glad they banned out OD, because that hero was crazy. And now we hop in to a Warlock ban for Mineski. Like a Juggernaut as well, being banned out. No big surprises there. I think those heroes pretty powerful in their own right. I do like the, you know, I do like having the Rubick there against Doom. You know, usually he pops the Scorched Earth and the before using Doom, so the only spell that you can really steal is Doom. So it's a good ability to get. Stealing Doom is always fun. But Ursa now getting banned out. Geek fam don't want to have to deal with that again. And Doombringer is a pretty tanky hero now. So having that Ursa. Having that Ursa chew right through him is definitely something that they want to try and avoid. So, you know, I can get behind that. They go for the Queen of Pain. All right, Mushy Quark. Radiant team pick. Mushy Quark. It is also a Mushy draft thing, actually. I just noticed the crown on his head. I mean, it's a group discussion, but I think Mushy is taking the reins. Probably. Geek fam. Third hero. All they go for here. Not too sure what they actually want to build towards here. Doombringer, I haven't seen him as much anymore, but usually he's run on the offlane. Could be run as a greedy 4 as well. Can roam pretty decently. They pick up a lion here, okay. Just that lockdown availability against the Queen of Pain. Makes sense to have that. Mineski, what do they want to go with their core? They have a Rubick, they have a Co-op, they have a Nyx Assassin. Does Mushy give his friends? Raging Potato. 5 seconds remaining. Luna again? Maybe some Tower Push? They need the Tower Push. The first game they won because of the Tower Push, so. And, We'll see if this hero gets picked up again. Luna's still decent, you know, even without Shadow Demon, still very decent. Adds to the push, the firepower, allows Rubick's harassment to actually do some decent damage. I quite like it. Issue of Weaver though. Okay, they go for the Kunkka again, so Adam gets his Kunkka again. They wanna, you know, sit on it. They don't want to pick their carry so fast. They might even go for something crazy like a Bloodseeker. I think they have done that in the past. Bloodseeker and then do stupid things. But we'll see if that's the case. Bloodseeker is really good on Weaver. I know Mushy has picked Bloodseeker before, guys. I know you might give me crap for it, but he has picked it before. He's the only guy that picked it. In C anyway. But maybe not. Templar Assassin, alright. A decent hero against the Queen. Gonna need that Sentry Ward in the middle lane to play around the Mel Dodge or Shadow Strike. Right. Fifth ban coming out. So looking at Geek Fam, they probably. Looking at Geek Fam, they probably have another support to go. Disruptor does look like a decent choice here against the Queen of Pain. A lifesaver might not be terrible either. But if we're running a greedy 4 here, maybe we still got space for another offlaner. Let's see if that's the case. See if the Geek fam go for the greed route. Because if they are, Mineski do have a last pick, so they can pick something to punish this, like a Luna to push fast. I'd like to see something like a Lycan as well. It's not terrible. Lycan, good for the pushing power. Maybe people haven't really worked around it yet. The Howl is really powerful as well. Shall see. Last pick here, coming out here for Geek Fam. Naga Siren, okay, last ban rather. I'm thinking of something that... Terrorblade? I think there was banned against Mineski earlier? Terrorblade could be possible here, Geek Fam. Yeah, I think Terrorblade is possible. Drow Ranger would be a greedy pick. It could be doable. Drow Ranger... Terrorblade. I think it's Terrorblade. Wouldn't be terrible. TB jokes. Hehe. Right. Oh, Furion? Furion got a buff as well. But I don't think they're gonna pick Prophet, to be honest. Not the team for it. Lifestealer. There you go. See, I knew that there was a space for some greed here. Weaver is going to be playing that support, so support Weaver for Geek Fam. We'll be seeing if it's as useful as the Weaver last game. We'll see if it's actually doable.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. 5 seconds remaining.
Last pick, Mineski. There you go. See, guys, I've been learning so much from Winter. I think some of it is finally rubbing off. Terrorblade. Oh. And in this case, pretty powerful. So long as he doesn't get doomed, it's a pretty solid lineup. They have the pushing power of the TB. You can shut down Lifestealer. You pretty much go ham on a lot of them. High armor as well, not too susceptible to a Templar. You can really kill some targets. I like it. Alright, we'll see what happens now as we hop into the game. Mineski or Geek Fam, which one takes the game? This qualifier for the Manila Masters. Really, really grueling. Holy crap.
5 seconds remaining.
Imagine Adam will be making a lot of space on this. He'll be making a lot of space on this Kunkka again. Alright, hopping into the game. Alright, introducing Geek Fam, finally on the Radiant side actually. Radiant side, Geek Fam, what is this set? What?
Prepare for battle.
Is this the recent one? What is this set? This armor looks nice. Some parts of it anyway, not all of it. I still like the Helm of Osmos. Well, pretty cool set. Doombringer, played by Velo. We have Teehee on the Templar Assassin. Where is that guy? Shonix on the Lifestealer. Rodgy on the Weaver. Lion, 10-10-10. And Mineski on the Dire side. We have Raging Potato, Terrorblade, Mushy on the Queen of Pain again. Rubik, Ninja Boogie. KYX, Yonix Assassin. And Adam. Who's going to be playing Kunkka? Lion good. GLHF. Old chat GLHF. After that game, you can only wish nothing but pleasantries. to maintain a
to maintain some level of sanity.
It's just been a crazy game. Clarity potion, cool. Is a support weaver. Okay. Alrighty. Hoppy into the gamey. Templar versus Queen of Pain middle. It's got some blocking going on, and Adam helps him block as well. So both sides are going to block the creep wave. We'll see which block is better, of course. Queen. Yep, doing the best. Block. And the winner is nobody. Well, TA got a slight advantage, I think, but yeah, a quick little aggro there means wave will be pulled, and that's a deny. Nope, the range creep. We'll see which range creep gets denied here. Oh, yeah, I think that's the most important one. Nope, doesn't get it. Throws out the Shadow Strike for that, though. So it doesn't get the deny. Now we'll see if the TA gets the deny on the range creep. Nope, doesn't. So Mushy and TA are going to be on even footing. We'll check out the lanes, see if there are any crazy lapses. Again, Torrent spam here in the middle lane, but yeah. Taking the ticks there, the Shadow Strike just breaking those Refraction Charges real quick. Mushy knows this matchup real well. Has taken quite a chunk of damage though. Has to be careful. Get a Tangle on him. Yeah, I get a Tangle given over to him. And TA already very low here. Mushy looking for another Shadow Strike, yeah. Dropping the Sentry Ward prevents the melee, but Templar Assassin has the Psionic Blades. The creep isn't sending any salves in. Oh, the Torrent, very close. Looking for a snipe there on the TA. But in the end, not going to happen there. Adam making a move there to the side. I like that play. Prevents the Shrining for Templar Assassin as well. So if he wants to Shrine, he has to head up to the top, which has already been spent by the Doombringer. Eating this creep. And there you go, there's the salve. So finally walking a salve up to himself, Adam sees it, and I think he will just back off now. How's Mushy looking? Rocky taking bounty runes, farming a little bit. And you already have TA point, but taking 2 points in that refraction. Oh, a double damage as well. Gonna start trading hits here with Teehee. The Torrent, oh, it's very perfect! It could be a kill. A clam as well, and one more hit, we'll do the job, double damage, ticks him down, Mushy scores first blood with the help of Adam, finally landing a Torrent, and getting that kill there. So starting off with, on a good note there, the Demons up top, trading hits there. Radiant Potato at the top of the CS charts, TA back in the fray, a very lucky double damage there from Mushy, allows him to get an advantage in this lane, and oh, now KYXY in deep doo-doo. Yep, doesn't even spike this. Poof! Spikes! Oh! KYXY, what a player! He's dead. Tsukuchi touches, and yeah. Okay. Nearly got out, guys. That was cool. That was cool. Nearly got out. Okay. They're gonna who stomp the Rubik. There's the lift back. Okay, they really want to go on him. The Scorched Earth is a spell, though, so... probably not gonna kill him, but they will be able to apply pressure to his tower. Orb of Venom, okay. Orb of Venom recently had a buff. It now does 5 DPS, and the poison duration is 3, so it does like 15 damage now. It ticks harder, but it ticks less, I think. Reduced by 1 second, but the damage comes in faster, so it might be a more viable form of harassment. Oh, setting EXP, taking that range peep will be cool. Does he get it? Nope. Adam being annoying. Stealing EXP, there you go. Templar Assassin going for jungle. Looking to steal the rune here. Meanwhile, Weaver trying to take a chance on that middle lane. Ah! You might just tick down to the Queen Dagger. Yeah, the Tangle will save his life. Yeah, Tangle will save his life. Arcane Rune here for Mushy. He hasn't even gone for the bottle. He's played this very aggressive Delver Null Talisman build, skipping bottle for the start. And just grabbing runes. Really, really like that play. Very well done here for him. Ninja Boogie. Now heading up. Dropping an Observer in the enemy jungle. This Orb of Venom just ticking Doom down. Just being annoying. And Terrorblade having that high armor means that he can actually absorb quite a few tower hits without caring as much.
Shernix. Blightstone, Orb of Venom, so double debuffs here on his right clicks. Rocky, meanwhile, has managed to get himself level 3 with this collection of bounty runes and absorbing farm here. Adam throws out the Tauren again. This annoys the hell out of the TA. Bucks come on to Adam, but Adam is okay. He's got a wind lace, he's got the boots, he'll survive. And Mushi finally has his bottle flown in. Gonna be able to do some work here. How's Ninja Boogie looking?
Nothing too crazy.
Rocky dropping wards here in the enemy side of the map. Terrorblade still top farm, 35 CS, Lifestealer sitting at a 30. Decent. Now has the face boots. Can actually put quite a lot of harassment onto the Nyx now. The supports can start leaving the lane as the Nyx will no longer be able to deal as much damage or stay in the lane without risking his life. Face boots makes a big difference in this matchup. Adam. Boots of speed, looking for a pick. There's Velo. He does have Doom now, he's level 6. Oh, they might look for him. Okay, Raging Potato. Does seem like a possible kill here. They have Inferno Blade. Oh, they're TPing in. Heroes, they want to make sure. There you go. And oh, they killed off TA again, but oh, I want to look for this. The Doom is there, but nope. Instant lift here. Okay. Fun's over, boys. Fun's over. But they got a kill on the TA again. Got the hit of the Tauren and the X-Mark. A nice little pick here on that TA. Getting bullied. Mushy, sick and tired of 99-minute games, back in full force. If anything, this guy has the patience to actually do this. He has the patience, he has the experience to not tilt. Nyx Assassin trying to squeeze out a level 6 here. Throws out the Impale, hits the Lifestealer. TA, level 6 at last. Skip points in the Meld and Sentry Ward. Adam will get the D ward going. And we got a lot of heroes rotating down. Doom is up. And we have a pause. Carla lagging. Yeah. Sea Surface taking a hit. Alright, so we'll have ourselves a short break, I think. Nope, G. 10-10-10. Not gonna have any of that. I'm gonna go straight into the. Trying to resume. Scream coming out again. Bushy. Playing the harassment game. 48 CS. Mana Burn coming out onto Shionix. Lifestealer. It's already annoying him a little bit. Adam, the Tauren. Still looking out for Velo. Velo has been wasting a lot of time here. Dire scans it, sees that. Radiant scans it, actually. Oh, Queen, they're gonna bait. Take the rune and bounce him back. Wow, the Kunkka abuse. Nicely done. 10 10 10. Sees the illusions. Lion has the mana drain to destroy it. That's 11 gold. Rocky taking a bit of damage here from the fruit pick. Trying to let him get out that level 6 for the spell steal. But so far, this Doom has not been able to get the pick that he wants. KYXY, bottom lane. Managing to get level 5 and a half. 5 and then some. Or both hit level 6 very, very soon. Shrining up. Getting the mana in. Take the bounty rune as well. Get that kill there. Oh, there's the lift forward. I think Rubik might be in trouble. They might just doom him. For shits and giggles. Are they gonna do it? No, they don't need it. They got him. Just trying to get out that level 6 though. And now the Lifestealer in trouble. They have gotten the X marks on him, but they haven't popped the Rage. Just chase him down with the Haste Rune. Not as easy a hero to kill and bully. And 10-10-10. Get a successful gank there for the Doom. So it's now 2 for 2. They safe using the Pentagram. And Shionix shivering there in his own jungle. Oh, look at that. Weaver Bomb. Looky, looky. Weaver Bomb. Weaver Bomb. No Sunder.
No thunder. Wow, Rodki dropping low. Shionix getting chased off, but it's a high armor Terror Blade. Hero actually losing his life, and now Doom is here. That's a big one to get. Doom is probably gonna get that kill. They have to deny him. They have to deny him. Rodki looking for the snipe. Looking for that snipe. Gets the tick. Oh, doesn't get it. Mushy. Gonna get that kill on the Doombringer, actually. Now Rodki in trouble. He's Sukuchi, still not off cooldown. There's the bait pop. There's the scream. And another kill for Mushy. He's now dominating. 4-0. All four kills belonging to Mushy. He is here, and he is not here to take prisoners. Queen of Pain. Doing work. Gotta get really far ahead to be a dominating force on that Queen of Pain. You don't want to lose sight of that advantage. You have to stay alive and play safe. Tower goes down. Golden threat, 10-10-10, hiding behind. Adam could get picked off. There's the slope. There's the Torrent as well. Nicely done. Slows down the TA, but TA is still going to get that kill. But Mushy jumping in. There is a melt. No, there's no refraction, but Mushy's not going to take that chance. Adam falls. That's a nice little pick to get. Rubick finally level 6. TA going to shrine up himself. Solo Shriner. Next assassin stuns up the Weaver. Who's now level 6, by the way. Ninja Boogie. Level 6 as well. Potato! Building into the Yasha for skipping Dragonlance, actually. Very interesting. Sometimes the Dragonlance is picked up for the health as well, mostly. Terrorblade has pretty poor health. Smoke up with the Mushy Gang. Observer Ward may or may not have scouted that. Scans available for the Radiant. Yeah, scans are available for the Radiant. They want to look for Doom, but it's going to be a tricky kill to get. Lion doesn't have detection, they're going to walk right into him. It's like, okay, get this guy. No, they want the Doombringer instead. The Torrent is there. They pick him off. The Sonic Wave as well, they got him. There's the Sonic Boom that goes across, but it's not enough. 10-10-10, now caught out by the Vendetta. They can't take him out. Mushy, still staying alive. Terrorblade is here. Blink away is Mushy. Weaver, keeping alive, but Adam finds him with the Torrent. Now Rage on Shionix, gonna prevent that slow. A Terror Blade with that ultimate is going to have that ability. I say ultimate, but it's kind of like an ultimate. The Metamorphosis here slams away at the tower, and I think they should be able to get that one easy. Should they? Oh, okay. Looks like they're gonna hold it. KYXY in trouble, gonna get doomed up, and that's him dying. So Torrent is there. Deny. Not gonna happen. The Taurus have been on point. Not gonna lie. Templar Trap. That's a nice one for Ninja Boogie to steal, actually. It's a lot of extra vision that will be afforded to him. That's, of course, if he stays alive for the duration. The Fate Bolts come in. He shows himself, so he pulls the Creep Wave. That's the Torrent as well. Gets the TA. Breaks her Refraction. Here comes the heals. Oh, X marks there on the Queen of Pain. Goes in there. They hex her up. They immediately pull her back. Perfect play off that X mark. Very well done. Now stealing Refraction. Didn't even plant any wards. Damn. Rubick could really have used that those psionic wards. Raging Potato. Oh, Nick Assassin himself caught out. There's the Torrent as well. Pushes Velo up, and there's the turnaround. The boat lands, and that's a Sonic Wave scream. I mean, pick him off. The Baby Dooms come out, throws pebbles at Mushy. But Mushy is not going to care. 6-0 right now. Not spending a Sonic Wave, actually. Just a scream of pain. Nice little play of the boat there by Adam. And they just didn't have enough damage without the Doom. The pressure piles on. Terror Blade still farming. The Yasha has already been picked up by him. Tower collapses. Mushy going for the Orchid once again. Really favors that item. The early aggression item. Instead of the early Aghanim stacks, he's some other Queen's build. Score's now 5-8. Let's take a look at net worth on both sides as well. Quite a bit of action. 1,000 gold in favor to Dire. Not too crazy, actually, given the look of things. Level 9 Doom, we'll see what path effects you can see here. 275 health, that's a lot of health. And 80 gold devour, which I think is also pretty crazy, but you never know. Kunkka now, still hiding there in the back. Has 4 points in Tauren, has maximized this for the stun and the damage. Lifestealer. Midas Lifestealer. Haven't seen this in a while, but given the state of the game, really feels that he could use the extra money. He's really trailing in net worth. Mushy crushing in his lane, and in the early phase at least. He's opting to build a very aggressive build here. The Orchid almost complete here. Dire scans. Looking for Geek Fam. Ten, ten, ten. Finger of Death ready. So this is something they want to use to get a quick kill. It's opportunity lost every minute or every second you don't get the kill with it because the cooldown's so long. It's a really good spell early. You really want to use it. It's got a long range too. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Here we go. Go Shadowblade in, Tsukushi as well. 10 10 10. Rocky. They're gonna mark it. There's the Radiant Scan. Looking for the push in. Adam not looking the right way. They're coming in. Rubick in trouble. They de-warp this. Oh no, the Doom immediately gets caught out. They silence him up as well. The boat, they're gonna walk right into it. The Finger of Death is there. Is it enough to kill off Mushy? That's Mushy going down. Velo in trouble. He dooms up the next assassin, but he's gonna lose his life. Terrorblade is here to take names. Aging Potato, so angry. The muted Nyx assassin still trying to run away. He's juking, he's juking. He doesn't get the jukes off. And in the end, they get the kill there. Do they get the punish on this Weaver? Nope, not gonna happen. Torrents are gonna miss. So in the end, it's a 3-for-3. Where's the teamfight recap? Did it pop out? Am I missing it? Okay, I probably missed it then. My bad. Didn't expect that to end so early. But here comes the Metamorphosis. Gonna start slamming away the tower, maybe farm it up a little bit. Potato going straight for the Manta Star. Really wants to put the damage out. And they pop the glyph, so kind of worked. The last few seconds of Metamorphosis, definitely worth it. Buckler being popped, they're going in. Walk under the Templar Ward, but they don't care. Oh, the Frost Armor is there immediately. Orchid as well. This Doombringer is not going to have a lot of fun. Walks right in back into the X Mark. The boat is there to receive him, and with the Orchid Bursts, they take him out. 8 to 12 now. Mineski. Looking good. Tower 2 now. Probably gonna go down as well. Really no real, like I said, no real counter push coming out from these heroes. So an aggressive play here with the Queen of Pain pushing lineup. It's just very strong for them. And Mushy having that X mark to constantly keep him out of harm's way and clearing out the wave, harassing is just so strong. Adam really likes that Kunkka. Adam didn't deny the tower. Oh, there's the bomb. Yep, they got him. Tauren, not gonna work. Tried to go for the pick here, but instant Tauren. Not enough to save his life. That's a nice little kill there. The Weaver bombs, really working out for them. Bushido. Now we'll see what he builds towards. The Aghanim Scepter is a possibility. Could be getting Eul's. Lincolns immediately. Aghanims. All possible items. Bushy's back. Gonna be farming here. Tier 1 tower in danger. The Finger of Death is off cooldown. The Doom as well.
denied ward. They're just gonna contend themselves with a tier 1.
Mineski.
9 to 12 for the Stokinet net worth, and slightly favoring the Radiant actually. In spite of the kill lead.
Did I read that right? Yeah. Favors the Radiant.
He got the 80 gold talon.
Right.
Start racking up the coins. Scan from the Dire. Fearing an ancient, fearing a Roshan. Well, it's not too terrible. There is a Templar Assassin for the minus armor. Koenig now picks up a Yasha. Going for the Sanjin Yasha. Okay, race car lifestealer. Already halfway to the Aghanim Scepter Weaver. Looks to be that Adam Shah from last game. Shrine pop tier 5 below. And we're back to Chilltown. This is chilling till Terrorblade gets big and push. Lion still doesn't have his blink dagger. They got the Rubik. Is there a blink? Nope, no blink. So they got the Rubik in with the blink TA. Nice little kill there, and this tower should be going down as well. Have that tower push. A lot of damage to this tower. Using Refraction to tank it up a little bit. Queen of Pain and Terrorblade will look to return the favor. Take out this tier 2 as well. Scans it, doesn't find any bad guys. Oh, down with the TPing, but there are no more tier 2 towers on that bottom lane. Top tower has fallen as well, so it's 1-for-1 trade. Really, this game has taken a real wind down after that game number 2. 99 minutes of crazy, crazy games. Alright, Key. 1,000 to go all the way from the time travel device. Gonna have that time lapse for allies. Vendetta scouting out the Roshan. X marks for Mushigan. Grab the rune. Grab it safely. There you go. Invis rune. Gonna make nothing out of it. I was still fearing what happened last game. Want to play a little bit more defensive till everything is done. Or Roshan spawns. Roshan's already there. Maybe they're trying to wait till they can Roshan without meta. Queen of Pain has the Invis rune, looking for targets at Lincoln Sphere on the mark. And whoa! They're going in, and I'm not sure the Dire know anything about this. Mushi, does he know? There is a blink on the Doom though. And Rocky goes in. Oh no, Mushi! Yep, Mushi's dead. And this tier 1 tower now gonna be in trouble as well. Torrin is there, but the Templar does have the Aegis. And GeekFam looking to push that advantage now. The early game slipping away from Mineski. Is it? Nick's still trying to farm it up. Looks like this wave will be stopped. As GeekFam are content with just a Mushi kill and an Aegis, they're gonna try and leverage that to get some space along with the map. Templar. Oh wow, maxing Devour over Infernal Blade. Just can't really blame him. Oh, Nyx Assassin, they scout him, they see him, they want him. Is there a steal? Steal Devourer, Rubik. Rubik. No, Rubik doesn't want a spell. I'm surprised Rubik didn't steal a spell, I didn't have any. Devourer would have been really nice for him.
Next level devourer as well. Alright. Here comes. Gonna have that silence onto that Lifestealer. Nick Assassin thinking he still had his Aether Lens and Aghanims. Not gonna happen. Not gonna get that kill. But they're posturing. Even against an Aegis lineup, they don't care. Rotki has the Aghanims now, so the life-saving is going to be in full force. It's very hard for Mineski to kill anyone now. They only have Queen of Pain to really blink in and start something. And they're just farming. Okay. Let's take a look at items. Lion, 500 gold. Not going to get his blink. Doom already has his blink, building to Shiva's. Slot. Weaver bring his buddy Lifestealer on an adventure again. You know, look for a target, pick him off maybe, and back off. And there you go, Weaver. Once again, still checking the surveillance, trying to get that pick on somebody. And they know that the Queen as well as the Omni going in, not Omni, the Kunkka. And it caught, throws out the boat. The mechanism as well is not going to be enough. That a Doom, meanwhile, finding Mushi again. This Queen of Pain just cannot catch a break. And they chop him down. That's gold, that EXP. And that's a Roshan they can really leverage here. Ninja Boogie steals off Shikuchi. That's a nice spell. But might be too far to, you know, too far ahead for them to deal with now. Still doesn't have his bottle though, Lion. I mean, still doesn't have his blink, Lion. I'm still hiding the trees. And they scout out a TB illusion. And TB does decide to go into the jungle. Here we go. Oh, Shikuchi Weaver. Potato deploys that and they're gonna go in right away. They start off another stun. Templar Assassin going in there. The Lifestealer dropping low. He does have the time lapse though. Time travels away out of his problems. Shikuchi is there. He's gonna infest in his buddy and has scoot out away to victory. Lion probably gonna get caught out here. Nice little jump there from that. Well, from that Rubik who is all getting melt shotted right down. Templar gets him. Now gonna armlet toggle his way. Toggles and TPs and he gets out. 10-10. There's the TA. His illusions. Or rather, his second life coming in. Mushi's back in the fray. The Destal Strikes are going. Torrent is there. They're gonna take out that kill. The Doombringer goes down. The bolt slams onto the TA. Shield or no shield. She's gonna get brought down. Raging Potato will claim those 2 credits. Alright, here we go. Not gonna try. There's the silence. Look on the lion. Yeah, screams and brought him down. Very nicely done. Overall, the kill score hasn't really changed that much. 14 to 17. Yeah. Adam. Middle lane. Oh, the stun comes out. Lifestealer. Once again, a very kiteable hero, and these heroes are good at it. Hero lift. There's the sentry ward. Gets rewarded right away. Oh, they're gonna stop the fight here. There's the silence onto the Doombringer. He got very quickly silenced there by Mushi. Still stunned. Gets time lapse out of his buddy with his buddy's ultimate, but there's the swap. Time swap keeping things cool here. The Terrorblade staying at healthy levels of health. Shionix in a lot of trouble. Nyx Assassin is there, doesn't have the stun, but he doesn't need it. Merely gonna get that kill. Lion in trouble as well. Reflection goes out. And TA. Take so much damage here. There's the next assassin. Yeah. There's the X mark. Oh no! 10-10-10! Thrown up on the high ground there by Adam. Gets himself picked off by a right click. Another silence here from Mushi. Gonna shut down the Weaver. And it's a 5-man wipe all of a sudden. Oh! Baby, a triple. Matter. Blobbed the tower once, he just used it, so he might be able to shoot another tower down. Oh, there, look at that. Swaps health with Adam. There we go, Doombringer. Doesn't know which one to doom. All of them. Tower. And back off. Alright, a few tower shots is enough to scare them. Yeah, I feel like over-respecting your opponents can be detrimental to you as well sometimes. Because of how you get the... Never mind. Trying to make a point there. Realized that it wouldn't fit. Adam, building towards the Gold Scepter straight away. Use the thing for farming. It's not terrible. Alright. Ninja Boogie. They have Blink Dagger as well. Terrorblade. Still holding on to the Tormentor. I want to switch to creeps now. And both teams playing Chill Dota. Playing Chill Dota. Let's look at that last kill. It's almost 37 minutes. No, not 37, 27. Oh, meanwhile. Now they just rage and run away. Okay. KYXY roaming in, looking for the enemy. It's gonna be tough. I know. I hear an X mark on the queen. Just keep her safe. Alright. So now we're gonna sit around the fireplace or the shrine. Sorry. Gotta. On the shrine, farm some ancients. Terrible illusions. There's the bugs, slows down the push. I don't think they're gonna stop anytime soon. Nick's assassin. Scout that one out. There's the observers. Then he'll immediately backs off. Fearing that there is something here? No. That's the Roshan about to go down again. Well, you get him. It's an FG, so it's only Roshan number 2. Oh no, here we go! Lifestealer. Does he get the time lapse off? No, he does not. Looks like Nick's assassin will be the sacrificial lamb. Just kidding. He does have the movement speed buff. They gotta pull him back. That's the Inferno Blade. The Screams though, doing so much damage. The Impales were catching him perfectly. And now Doom, the last one to stay alive. The hit coming out, tries to get the hit there on the Rubik. Got himself an ultra kill given away. And, oh. And now they're going for the base. Terror Blade's alive, and there is buyback on. Doom and Lifesteal, Mom and Dad, I think. But now all the towers. The Rexes are all gonna fall soon. Here we go. Taking one Rex here. Shrines are gonna be open. And that's Roshan. Gonna go down to Mineski. The net worth's gonna start separating. Alright. Meanwhile, there's two wards sitting side by side. And the Roshan goes down. So, 34-14. Roshan goes down.
Mecca. Blink forward again. Shrine. Blink dagger, hit forward, ninja boogie. Slowing up the Weaver Tsukuchi was a big deal, I told you. Alright, still runs away. Gets out there before the creep wave chases him. $21k net worth there on the Terror Blade. Wow. This game has managed to reach into the 35 minute mark. I did call 30 minutes in, but I guess that's not the case. TB, I thought it would be the hero that just really goes ham on your towers. Shrine's in trouble. There you go, pushing in KYXY. Looking in the middle, but it's already empty. Oh no, they silence up the TA. TA now BKB's up. We'll dodge that mostly. But we'll have to use that BKB defensively. So it's definitely not a good idea. And go stuck outside their base. Lifestealer, the only way in. Oh, there you go. Nyx Assassin moving him forward with Little Boy. Here it goes. Raging Potato looking to close this game up 2-1 so that we can all get out of here after game 2. Feel like nothing will match that now. Oh, Shionix pops the rage a little early. So that's gonna be spell immunity down, and they know TB gonna start slamming away the towers. Rainy Potato. Still holding on to that Manta style. Does have that Aegis of Immortal. Butterfly picked up there, 36 minutes. This guy going crazy right now. There's still illusion. Still clearing them out. Torrent gets hit, there's the stun that comes out, it does miss there. Tia gets brought back and immediately BKBs again defensively. There is going to be the boat, makes everyone tankier. And there's a Sonic Wave, finds him, Shionix. Scouted by Mushy, brings down the tier 3 towers. This game doesn't look like it will go to 99 minutes. Mineski are looking to slam the second set of Rexes into the ground as 37 minutes creeps up on us. And here we go. There's the jump in again. Mushy once again with the Shiva save. Wrap around there. Looking for the bottom lane. Just calculated Dota. They don't want to take any risks. Quipping going down there. Now this real one. Gonna be doing against the tower. Terrorblade, meanwhile, going in there, beating away the last set of melee Raxes here for the Raiden. Geek fam have to go in now. The Doom goes in. Yeah, there you go, Potato. He doesn't really care. They need the Doom, and they do Mushy. Mushy, I guess, is the only one they can really do, but they counter Doom him, so Doom gets Doom. Doomception happening here. And who's this Lifestealer getting jumped back there by the Weaver? Gonna try chopping him. There's the Finger of Death, it does miss though. Immediate Sunder coming at him from Raging Potato, saves the Kunkka's life because he does have the Aegis, he doesn't really care. And he's going to take that life and respawn with it full and everything. Here you go, Templar Assassin as well. Instant Hex onto that poor Raging Potato. And oh, is it going to be enough? Raging Potato going in for the Rexes, he doesn't care. Does he die? No, one more drop. One more tick! One more tick! Do they do it? TA, meanwhile, getting a triple kill. Queen? Yeah. Here we go. Can't wait to do it. Lion pushes up Central.
Observer Wards. This game, almost all but over. This last range rack's the only thing standing between Geek Fam and Mega Creeps. Worth 20,000. I mean, this game was pretty textbook for them. Terrorblade just crushing the lanes with the Queen of Pain, and then using that tempo to take buildings. A smart play. Yeah, Kunkka helping middle gank a little bit, destroying that mid laner was very significant. One Tauren removes a refraction. Very strong. Go. Rubik. Aghanim's Dust. Kunkka has the Solar Crest, Ghost Scepter, and Guardian Greaves. Pretty rich. Well, here you go. Last Rex. Gonna happen soon. But Rocky gonna go for the Hail Mary play. I think if they lose this fight, they're out. They're gonna be out of the count. Oh, immediately breaking the smoke there. X marks the spot. Does have the BKB. Immediately blinks away. Avoids the Tauren. Yeah. Geek Fam. Elo. Needs to get that damage going. X mark on the Terrorblade. Terrorblade doesn't care. Goes in there, strikes it down. That's Mega Creeps, right? Yep, that's Mega Creeps. Are they fighting this, really? Alright, they're fighting this. I guess with that, it's going to close out the series 2-1. And after game number 2, it's kind of a Debbie Downer. Is that the term? It's a little bit of a downer. And, Mineski should claim this game with Mega Creeps on the way. Alright. Mega Creeps. Is it going to happen here? Not gonna GG out. They're just gonna play this one till the end. Shionix. Goes on a creep wave. Look at that net worth. Look at it. Just look at it. So little they can do here. Him some Rubik. Oh man, his doom's gonna last forever, and he can just switch spells really quick. Okay. Double damage. Still farming. Mega Creeps are already moving in. There you go. Real Mega Creeps. Yeah, Raging Potato. Still playing it very safe. Not wanting to risk anything like game number 3 earlier. Sending illusions in. At this point, I think you really have to go in for this because there's no other way in. Yeah, you could wait for them to grow off the high ground, but gotta really catch up to them to get it. And Rocky. Pushing out a creep wave. Items. Lincoln's BKB, Shiva's for the Queen. Good protection items. This Rubik! I guess with a Rex, it's not too bad to get a. There you go. Still holding on to this Mega Creep wave. Not Diffusal. Abyssal Blade and Sanjin Yasha is up running on him. TA. BKB as well. A lot of BKBs, it's just a matter of whether they pop in time. And Roshan's up. So Roshan's up, they're gonna take that Aegis, and they're gonna march down mid, right? Find him. Terrorblade's here to rescue today.
Roshan down. 44-29. Shonix. Wonder what will happen this game that will cause them to lose, because it does look like the enemy doesn't know. They missed the memo. Here comes the Hurricane Pike. It's the illusion. Yeah. Oh, Terrorblade flutters forward. Looking for a Doom pick, but Doom a little bit too quick for him. And now immediately Matter Form is deployed. They have one last chance. There we go. Popping it. The bugs out here as well. The final hoorah. There's the blink in. They're immediately onto Adam, actually. Of all people. Gonna stun him up. They have the Sonic Wave. They blow up the Weaver. That's the Weaver down. The Time Traveler is out of the count. And somehow, Raging Potato survives to get that kill. They're gonna buy back into the game there. Stunning on the Nyxassin. Nyxassin gets melted down. They're gonna do enough there. They'll retreat back to base. They're just going for the throne right now. Moshi as well. Objective base gamers. Tower gets brought down. And yeah, with that, I think they're gonna mop things up. They kill off three heroes. Lifestealer buys back into the fray. Rubick loses his life, but with Weaver, Doom, TA about to fall, Lifestealer already buying back. It's going to be a tall order to stay alive. There is the Lion getting shot down, screamed down, and brought down. It could be a GG very, very shortly. The illusions are doing so much damage. And there you go. Brought him down. Doom is dead. TA is dead. Full buyback coming out here. That's the last one they got. It's a good game, well played. And the Mega Creeps got him. So, after 46 minutes, Mineski take a very simple game out of Geek Fam.